Actually, towards the end of intern year, I was feeling pretty down on myself and kind of burnt out with internal medicine. This happened around May, and it was actually, funnily enough, right after the video where I said, medicine is so interesting and sometimes, and I really love medicine. And I just want to say that I really don't want to portray an image of myself where it's like, oh, medicine is amazing 100% of the time, and I'm like having such a great time. I don't want to be one of those like social media influencers who is just like trying to like make their life seem like the most perfect thing possible, because residency is really hard. I think I've had a lot of self-doubts on a lot of things and insecurities, and I think overall I'm still doing a really good job, but sometimes I feel like there's a lot of combination of reasons why I've not been feeling so good. So I guess this video is kind of going to be a vlog for anybody else who's feeling kind of down in residency too, and kind of talking about the strategies we can use to start feeling better even when we're feeling pretty burnt out. Because I think no matter what you do, if you're working like 80-hour weeks all the time, you're coming home and you're studying more, you're going to start to feel a little burnt out at some point during residency. It's kind of inevitable. And even for me, I feel like I'm generally a pretty positive guy, but it kind of wears on you. It's kind of a grind, and it can get really tiring sometimes, especially when you're doing a lot of non-medicine related things and you feel like you're not really making a difference. You're doing a lot of social work and things you weren't trained in, like sending faxes and getting outside records and trying to figure out how to get a SNF approved for a patient or get their insurance approved for a medication. It's all stuff that we're not good at, so it feels bad when we're doing it because we've never received formal training on it. It's just something we have to fill in and do. And then two, it's like not what we're here to do. Like, we're here to practice the medicine and learn about all the interesting stuff that we can treat and diagnose, rather than doing all this more practical kind of side of stuff, which is important, but kind of sucks when that becomes like your main job. I will say that in general, I feel like people enjoy doing things that they're good at. And throughout residency, I think you're gonna find that, you know, you're constantly rotating between one rotation to another rotation, and you're constantly feeling a sense of, I need to learn more, I don't know enough yet, and I'm not good enough yet. And you're at the same time, you're also comparing yourself to other people all the time. And you know, when you look at other people, they always seem to know exactly what's going on, and everybody gets imposter syndrome. I think almost everybody experiences imposter syndrome, even if you have all the objective signs pointing against you having imposter syndrome. And so it's a really tough field because you feel like you never are comfortable. You're never in your comfort zone. And it's a lot more difficult to develop that confidence. Like, you know, if you liked math when you were growing up and you were good at math, you know, that was pretty cool and you enjoyed doing it because of that. Like, I remember when I was in school, I liked all the subjects because I was pretty good at like history and math and English. I was really good at school in general, so I really liked all the subjects I was learning. But when you feel like you're not up to your own standard, it can make you feel pretty worn down after a while. So anyways, going on to the top few things that I think will make a difference in helping you avoid burnout in residency. I think the number one thing that I have not been doing well is getting enough sleep. And actually, I had been getting more sleep than I had been in medical school. But if you look at my Notion tracking of my sleep, you can see that I basically never get 8 hours of sleep. And I think over time, that really, really compounds. The times that I did sleep more, I definitely was in a better mood and feeling a lot better. So this is a pretty obvious one, and I think you already know this, but we need to get more sleep and we need to prioritize sleep in residency, especially if you're somebody who has not prioritized sleep in the past. And if you're watching this video, I honestly feel like you're probably kind of like me. You like watching YouTube videos, you probably like going on Reddit, you like going using the internet a lot, and sometimes that eats into your sleep. So one thing that we had to do is just get used to going to bed super early. Like, we had to prioritize going to bed at 9:30 or 9 p.m., which is something I can never do. Like, so if I can go to sleep at 10:30, that'd be really good for me. But if you're starting to feel down and out during residency, first thing to look into is how can you get more hours of sleep? That's definitely a big one. Next thing is exercise, and this is a pretty much no-brainer as well. I'm not really gonna go too much into that. Come on, you guys know you guys gotta exercise. I've been exercising a lot more. I think I've been doing mainly weightlifting. I got this home gym. Let me just go show you. You know, if you've watched my other videos, you've probably seen the home gym already, but having this home gym here and having some goal to strive to with my roommate has been really great. And we've been making some small gains, which is pretty fun. But honestly, I think one big thing to do would be to do more cardio, because I think cardio actually has a little bit better of mood improving effects compared to weightlifting. So if there's one thing that I would work on more, it is doing more cardio. I got this DDR pad from Poland, And the thing is, when I haven't been doing well, it's been the times where I haven't been using my DDR pad as much. This is a metal pad from Poland. It took a long time to set it up. But we got to do more cardio. You got to exercise more to feel better. And it really releases a lot of endorphins. So prioritize exercising a little bit more in residency as well. The third thing that I want to mention is doing a habit of daily gratitude. And this was something that I had talked about in a previous video and I had been doing for quite a while. But one of the things that happened is I started falling off of it a little bit, and you can see on my Notion thing, my previous amount of times I was doing daily gratitude, and then you can see that I was like really falling off at a certain point, and I was doing less journaling as well. And those were times that I really wasn't reflecting as much on the positive things in my life, and I think was making me feel a lot worse too, because I wasn't really appreciating or being grateful for some of the good things in my life. So I think, you know, besides sleeping more, exercising more, you know, doing more daily gratitude is going to be something that really will help you with those times when you're feeling burnt out in residency. One thing that I've actually been considering is actually switching to a more physical way of journaling, maybe with an iPad and an Apple Pencil as kind of like a hybrid with, you know, it saves it digitally, but you're also still getting the experience of writing things down versus going full pen and paper or just staying digitally. I'm trying to weigh the pros and cons of each. And if you have any opinions on that, I would love to hear your thoughts on doing physical journaling versus digital journaling. I think writing things physically is like a nice chance to disconnect from the internet. I think it makes you be a little bit more focused when you're actually writing things down, and a little more mindful of what you actually want to write, because it takes a lot more effort to write things down. And it's just a lot more peaceful because you're getting away from the screens that you're doing all your work on and you're getting your notifications on and stuff like that. So let me know in the comments what you think about using a physical planner and journal versus a digital one. Next is something that we've been ingrained to do, which is that we care a lot about other people's expectations of us. So I guess my fourth tip is to really, at this point, we need to start caring a lot more about our own expectations of ourselves and not caring so much of others' perceptions of us. And it's really hard because, you know, medical school, we're constantly being evaluated and we're constantly judging our own selves based on others' perceptions of us. If they perceive us as doing a great job, then we feel good. And then if people are not giving us like praise for doing a good job, we feel like we're doing a terrible job. But I think a lot of things that you do in residency goes unnoticed. A lot of the good work that you do is unnoticed. And then sometimes you may feel like you make a mistake and then, you know, people harp on that. But they didn't notice all the 10 other good things you did that day, which really sucks. But I think we have to switch more to a mindset of knowing the good stuff that we have done and be satisfied with our own work by ourselves. I feel like I went through a really big phase of feeling down maybe back in May or so, because I felt like my residency program didn't really understand me. They kind of misunderstood me and felt like I was trying to criticize them or something. And then I also felt like they weren't appreciating, you know, some of the things I was trying to work on. And so it felt really bad. I felt like I was very misunderstood at that time. But now looking back at it, I mean, I still kind of feel a little bit salty about it, I guess. You know, I feel like everybody just is in their own bubble, and so they don't notice the good things that you're doing or the effort that you're putting in. And so we had to stop relying so much on other people's perceptions of us. So tip number four is really to just kind of be your own biggest cheerleader and not worry so much about what others think about you. Tip number five, and this is something I'm still working on myself, is to kind of make sure you definitely cut out all the toxic people in your life. Anybody who brings any negativity to your life, there's no reason to be interacting with them more. You want to find a close group of friends. You want to get a close support system so that when you are feeling down, you have somebody to talk to and to rely on. And also, I think a good thing to do, and something that I have not done very well, is reaching out to some of your friends back from home and staying in touch with them a little bit more, because I think it keeps you grounded. It makes you feel more fulfilled by, you know, keeping in touch with people, with family. And that's an important thing to do during residency. You really got to make sure you don't lose yourself in residency and your whole life becomes consumed by medicine, that you kind of like lose all these connections that you've had in the past. So that's something I'm working on and I think will be a good thing for reducing burnout. Another thing that I noticed when I was feeling bad was that during the periods that I was feeling down, I wasn't doing as much teaching. And I feel like that was one of the things that I enjoyed doing the most. And for some reason, there was a period of time where I felt like I didn't have a lot to offer, or I didn't have a lot to teach, and I wasn't teaching the med students. And I felt really bad about it. Honestly, even if there's some barriers or there's some reason that you're a little hesitant to teach, like I think maybe I had been intimidated because I felt like the med students were already too smart and I didn't have that much to offer them. But even in that situation, I think you always have something to offer, and doing something that makes you feel personally gratified, I think, is something to prioritize still. Like, if you enjoy teaching, do more teaching. Don't try and make excuses for why you shouldn't do it and then feel bad about it later. Lastly, residency is always gonna have ups and downs. There's just no way around it. And you know, you're gonna have 24-hour calls, 28-hour calls. You're gonna be thrown into night shifts and then switching back to days. And I think that's like the worst in terms of when I started to feel bad, is when I kept going from nights to days. And I'm pretty good at like switching my sleep schedule around, but it definitely impacts your mood. So you gotta utilize all of these tips in order to create a buffer for when those ups and downs happen. And so when the downs come, you have already built up like a reserve to get you through it. Please like the video if you found this useful, and please comment in the comments below if you have any ideas about avoiding burnout, or if anything was particularly useful or connected with you. And again, I hope this was useful, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. See you.